Good morning, students. Welcome to Value Education class. Please take out your book and open page number 27. Unit 5, attention. Today we will do reading of this unit. Unit 5, attention. An incident from the epic Mahabharata teaches us about concentrations. The Pandavas and the Kauravas had a guru called Dronacharya. One day, after a class in archery, Dronacharya told the princess, "I have taught you all that I know. Now you have to show me what you have learnt." He asked the princess to carry their bows and arrows and follow him. Meanwhile, the Acharya made a clay model of a bird. He painted the eyes and beak black and the rest a deep brown color. Then he told one of the princes to climb a tree. "Take this bird and place it on the topmost branch." Then he asked the princes, "Can all of you see the bird on the topmost branch? As I call out your name, you have to pierce the bird's left eye with your arrow." Dronacharya called out Yudhishthira's name first. As Yudhishthira came forward to shoot the arrow, Dronacharya asked, "My son, what do you see?" Yudhishthira replied, "Guruji, I can see the tree, the branches, the green leaves, and a bird sitting on a branch." The Acharya was unhappy with his answer and turned to ask Bhima the same question, "What do you see, Bhima?" "I can see a branch and the bird perched on it," Bhima replied. Yet again, the Acharya was not satisfied with the answer. Dronacharya asked all the princes the same question but was unhappy with their answers. The Acharya was angry and the princes got scared to look into his eyes. Finally, Arjuna picked up his arrow to aim at the bird and the Acharya asked him the same question. "Guruji, I see the left eye of the bird," Arjun replied. Then he confidently aimed the arrow exactly on the bird's left eye and it fell down. Dronacharya was finally happy. He told the other prince, "You were not concentrating on the task at hand. You were all distracted. If you want to be successful, you have to concentrate." You cannot learn to concentrate in a day. You have to make it a habit. Decide on what you want to complete. Fix a time to finish your work. Keep all the things that you need for your task near you, or you will get distracted and keep getting up again and again to look for them. Ask your family members not to interrupt or disturb you when you are working. Eat well, exercise and get enough sleep. This will help you feel fresh and energetic. Dear students, successful people have achieved their aim in life through concentrations and hard work. When you sit to study, think of all the things that disturb your concentrations. The phone may ring, your brother or sister may be enjoying a cartoon show on televisions, you may smell something delicious being cooked in the kitchen. Whatever the disturbance, your aim should be to focus and study hard. You have to make a choice and turn your attentions to your books. Thank you and have a nice day.